wisdom way, running in honor one more night it's free. I met a fellow rebel, and to me did say, we have orders from our captain to assemble at Dunbar. But how are we to get there without a motor car?
Oh, Barney, dear, be of good cheer, I'll tell you what we'll do. The specials, they are plentiful, but the IRA are few. We'll send a wire to Johnson to meet us at Stranraer, and we give the boys a bloody good ride in Johnson's motor car.
When Dr. Johnson heard the news, he soon put on his shoes. He said, this is an urgent case, there is no time to lose. He then put on his castor hat and on his breast a star. You could hear the din all through the wind of Johnson's motor car.
Ah, but when he got to the railway bridge, the rebels he saw there.
Our Johnson knew the game was up, for at him they did stare. He said, I have a permit to travel near and far.
To hell with your English permit, we want your motor car.
What will my loyal brethren think when they hear the news? My car, it has been commandeered by the rebels at Dunluce. We'll give you a receipt for it, all signed by Captain Barr.
Come on, Ireland, get your freedom, boy, you'll get your motor car. We'll aim for that car in motion and build it to the brim. With guns and bayonets shining, which made old Johnson grim. At Barney, hoist with a Sinn Féin flag and another like a star. And we give three cheers for the IRA and Johnson's motor car.
Sweet County Limerick, one cold winter's night. Oh, the turf fires were burning when I first saw the light. And a drunken old midwife went tipsy with joy as she danced round the floor with her slip of a boy.
Singing Banyan, Bois and Dona, and the juice of the barley for me.
Well, when I was a gossoon of 8 years or so, with me turf and me primer to school I did go. To a dirty old schoolhouse without any door, where lay the schoolmaster blind drunk on the floor.
Saying, Bunyan, Mois and Gona, and the juice of the barley for me.
At the learning, I wasn't such a genius, I'm thinking. I wasn't much at poetry, either. But I soon bet the master entirely at drinking. Not a wake or a wedding for 5 miles around. But myself in the corner was sure to be found.
Singing Bunyan, Lois and Gona, and the juice of the barley for me.
One Sunday the priest read me out from the altar, saying you'll end up your days with your neck in a halter, and you'll dance a fine jig between heaven and hell. And his words, they did fright me, the truth for to tell.
Singing Bunyan, Bois and Gona, and the juice of the barley for me.
So the very next morning, as the dawn it did break, I went down to the vestry, the pledge for to take. And there in that room sat the priests in a bunch, round a big roaring fire drinking tumblers of punch.
Sing Bunyan, Bois and Gona, and the juice of the barley for me.
Now this is a sad verse. Well, from that day to this, I have wandered alone. I'm a jack of all trades and a master of none, with the sky for me roof and the earth for me floor. And I'll dance out me days drinking whiskey galore.
Singing Bunyan, Bois and Gona, and the juice of the barley for me.
O'Driscoll drove with a song. The wild duck and the drake from the tall and tufted reeds of a drear heart lake. And he saw how the reeds grew dark with the coming of night tide. And he dreamt of the long, dim hair of Bridget, his bride. Then he heard it high up in the air, a piper piping away. And never was piping so sad, and never was piping so gay. Then he saw young men and young girls dance in a level place, with Bridget his bride among them, with a sad and a gay face. The dancers gathered around him, and many a sweet thing said. An old man brought him red wine, and a young girl white bread. But Bridget drew him by the sleeve, away from the merry band, to old men playing of cards with a twinkling of ancient hands. And he sat and he played in a dream, and he thought not of evil chance, till one bore Bridget his bride away to the merry dance. He bore her away in his arms, the handsomest young man there, and his lips and his neck and his arms were drowned in her long dim hair. O'Driscoll scattered the cards, and out of his dream awoke. And old men and young girls were gone like a drifting smoke. Then he heard it high up in the air, a piper piping away. And never was piping so sad, and never was piping so gay.
As I was sitting by the fire talking to O'Reilly's daughter, suddenly I got them into me head like somebody O'Reilly's daughter.
Giddy-ay-ay, giddy-ay-ay, for the one-eyed O'Reilly, giddy-ay-ay. Right on your old big drum.
Well, O'Reilly played on the big bass drum. O'Reilly had a mind for more than a sloth. O'Reilly had a bright red lips and eye, and he kept that tie a little blade off.
Giddy-ay-ay, 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 for the one-eyed O'Reilly, giddy-ay-ay. Right on your old big drum.
Her hair was black and her eyes were blue. The colonel and the major and the captain saw to the sergeant and the private and the drummer boy too. But the drummer had a chance with O'Reilly's daughter.
Giddy-ay-ay, 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 for the one-eyed O'Reilly, giddy-ay-ay.
Well, I got me a ring and a parson too, and I got me a scots and a married father. Settle me down to a peaceful life, happy as a king with O'Reilly's daughter.
Giddy-ay-ay, 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 for the one-eyed O'Reilly, giddy-ay-ay. Well, you old big drum.
Suddenly a footstep on the stair. Who should it be but O'Reilly out for slaughter, with two pistols in his hand, looking for the man that had married his daughter.
Giddy-ay-ay, 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 for the one-eyed O'Reilly, giddy-ay-ay.
Well, I caught O'Reilly by the hair, and it dumped his head in a pail of water. Where his pistols into the air, that's like quicker than him and his daughter.
Giddy-ay-ay, 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 for the one-eyed O'Reilly, giddy-ay-ay. Right on your own big drum, fresh fish.
While I sing, for the love of one's country is a terrible thing. It banishes fear with the speed of a flame, and it makes us all part of the patriot game. My name is O'Hanlon, and I'm just gone 16. My home is in Monaghan, where I was weaned. I've learned all my life cruel England to blame, and so I'm a part of the patriot game. It's barely 2 years since I wandered away with a local battalion of the bold IRA. I'd read about heroes and I wanted the same to play up my part in the patriot game. This island of ours has for long been half free. 6 counties are under John Bull's tyranny. So I gave up my boyhood to drill and to train, to play my own part in the patriot game. And now as I lie here, my body all holds, I think of those traitors who bargained and sold. I wish that my rifle had given the same to those quislings who sold out the patriot game.
Heart, their marshal's drum has heard from far to Donegal. the Legion of the Rear Guard.
She the Van Boleyn Bull, the bear grach to vein yin, the goohi vra vei shell of merla, his to deal talish na gaula.
O roche da ba awalya, o roche da ba awalya, o roche da ba awalya, and in shell hot and powry,
a wheel arena back of Beckham, monomem bio in the year back shockton, Grania wheel agus mil agus giacht, et bogart man gaula.
O roche da ba awalya, o roche da ba awalya, o roche da ba awalya, an ishel hapan tauri.
Ta Grania wheel Chaptar sala, oigli karm halle margarda, gelit fenis ni frank na spanig, is kriks hir ruiger kaula.
One pleasant evening in the month of June, as I was sitting with my glass and spoon, a small bird sat on an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch.
Toor-a-loor-a-loo, toor-a-loor-a-lay, toor-a-loor-a-loo, toor-a-loor-a-lay. A small bird sat on an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch.
One more diversion can a man desire than to sit him down by a snutter fire, upon his knee a pretty wench, I and on the table a jug of punch.
Toor-a-loor-a-loo, toor-a-loor-a-lay, toor-a-loor-a-loo, toor-a-loor-a-lay, upon his knee a pretty wench, I and on the table a jug of punch.
Let the doctors come with all their art, they'll make no impression upon my heart.
Like that punch.
Even the cripple forgets his punch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch.
And toor-a-loor-a-loo, toor-a-loor-a-lay, toor-a-loor-a-loo, toor-a-loor-a-lay, even the cripple forgets his punch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch.
And if I get drunk, well, the money's me own, and them don't like me there.
Someday I'll go back again to Ireland. And my dear old wife would only pass away. She nearly has my heart broke with her nagging. He's got a mouth as big as Galway. See her drinking 16 pints of Pabst Blue Ribbon. Commercial. And then she can walk home without a sway. If the sea was beer instead of salty water, she would live and die in Galway Bay. See her drinking 16 pints at Pat Joe Murphy's. The barman says, I think it's time to go. Well, she doesn't try to speak to him in Gaelic, in a language that the clergy do not know. On her back she has tattooed a map of Ireland. And when she takes her bath on Saturday, she rubs the sunlight soap around by Tlada, just to watch the suds flow down by Galway.
Danny Boy.
As they say at home, I'm they.
When I was young, I had no sense. I bought a fiddle for 18 pence. The only tune that I could play was Over the Hills and Very Far Away. So early in the morning, so early in the morning, so early in the morning, before the break of day. When I was young, I had no sense.
Last summer, when we went home to Ireland, we threw a party for our little nieces and nephews, the children of the family. And they sang their children's songs and played their children's games. And we fell in love with our own childhood songs all over again. We're going to sing some of them for you now.
When I was young, I had no sense. I bought a fiddle for 18 pence. The only tune that I could play was Over the Hills and Very Far Away. So early in the morning, so early in the morning, so early in the morning, before the break of day.
One of the first songs that I can ever remember singing as a child was to a snail. In the mornings when they left those little silver trails behind them, we used to pick up snails and sing this song to them to try and coax them out of their shell and try and get them to put their horns out. Except we didn't call them snails, we called them shellicky bookies.
Shellicky, shellicky, bookie, put out all your horns. All the ladies are coming to see ya.
Shellicky, shellicky, bookie, put out all your horns. All the ladies are coming to see ya.
And then in Armagh, where I was born and raised, thanks be to God, the first thing... The first thing you're likely to hear when you've been rocked to sleep would be something like, up the long ladder and down the short rope to hell, King Billy, and God bless the Pope. If that didn't do, we'll tear him in two, we'll send him to hell, he's that white and blue.
There was a song that we used to sing about the sea. And like the snail became the shillikibuki, the sea was called the Illy Ally O.
There's a big ship sailing on the Illy Ally O, the Illy Ally O, the Illy Ally O. There's a big ship sailing on the Illy Ally O. Hi ho, the Illy Ally O. There's a big ship sailing, rocking on the sea, rocking on the sea, rocking on the sea. There's a big ship sailing, rocking on the sea. Hi ho, rocking on the sea. There's a big ship sailing back again, back again, back again. There's a big ship sailing back again. Hi ho, back again. Hi ho, back again.
The town where we were bread and butters, as they say, was about 20 miles from the sea, and there was a river flowed right through the town. And on summer evenings, when you had those high tides and the river was swollen, sounds were carried very clearly from one bank to another. And as children were playing on lovely sounding places like Ash Park, Ballylinch, and the Well Field, you might hear something like this on a summer's evening, echoing across the high tide.
Ahem, ahem, me mother has gone to church. She told me not to play with you because you're in the dirt. It isn't because you're dirty, it isn't because you're clean, it's because you have the whooping cough and eat margarine.
That's the low price bread.
Wallflowers, wallflowers growing up so high.
He had the measles, he'll never, never die. Call to Paddy Clancy's house, he has no relations. He may tick and tack and turn his back and kiss the congregation. Wallflowers, wallflowers, growing up so high. He had the measles, he'll never, never die. Call to Tommy Makem's house, he has no relations. He may tick and tack and turn his back and kiss the congregation.
Mary the money, she's getting so funny, she won't be left out till St. Patrick's Day. She's sparing the brass for to buy a jackass for to bring her to Mass of a Sunday.
Frosty weather, snowy weather, when the wind blows, we all go together.
Frosty weather, snowy weather, when the wind blows, we all go together.
There was a man of double deed who sowed his garden full of seed.
When the seed began to grow, 'twas like a garden full of snow.
When the snow began to fall, like birds it was upon the wall.
When the birds began to fly, 'twas like a shipwreck in the sky.
And when the sky began to crack, 'twas like a stick upon my back.
And when my back began to smart, 'twas like a penknife in my heart.
And when my heart began to bleed, then I was dead and dead indeed.
Those were the sort of gruesome things that we used to come up with as children. And on the cold, frosty nights, when you'd build a big fire at home, start telling ghost stories about the banshee and things like that. But children can be very cruel, you know. And we used to do a very cruel thing coming on towards Christmas. We used to go out with big novelty sticks out through the fields and kill a little bird called the wren. Harmless little thing. And we'd put the corpse in the middle of a holly bush, and we decorated with the ribbons and colored papers and things like that. And then on the day after Christmas, on St. Stephen's Day,
We'd blacken our faces and dress up in women's clothes and all sorts of mad things and go around from door to door singing this song and collecting money for the funeral. And the song that we sang as we went around from door to door was called The Ran Song.
There ran, there ran, the king of all birds since Stephen's day was cutting up furs. Although he was little, his honour was great. Jump up, me lads, and give us a treat. As I was going to kill and all, I met a ran upon the wall. Huddle me wattle and knocked him down and brought him into Carrick town.
Crawling, drooling, where's your nest? Is in the bush that I love best. In the tree, the holly tree, where all the boys do follow me.
Pop it a kettle and down with a pan and give us a penny to bury the ran.
I followed the ran 3 miles or more, 3 miles or more, 3 miles or more. Follow the run 3 miles or more, it's 6 o'clock in the morning.
I have a little box on the me arm, on the me arm, on the me arm. I have a little box on the me arm, a penny or tuppence would do it no harm.
Mrs. Lassie's a very good woman, a very good woman, a very good woman. Mrs. Lassie's a very good woman, she gave us a penny to bury the run.
Penny to bury the run, Mrs. Lassie.
It never really sounded like that, though, on St. Stephen's Day. When you'd wake up in the cold, grey, wet dawn of Ireland, on St. Stephen's Day, you'd hear all the different groups of Wren boys, some of them singing it as fast as they possibly could to get from one door to another to get more money. But then there was always the ethnic folk types who sang it slowly and deliberately. They never made any money, of course. But they ended up in Carnegie Hall. You should hear the conglomeration of voices in the street below. And it all sounded garbled and sounded like this.
And then in Armagh, the north of Ireland, around Christmas and New Year, we had a carol that was sort of particular to that part of the country for that time of the year. And it went up the long ladder and down the short rope to hell with King Billy and God bless the Pope. That doesn't do, we'll tear him in two and we'll send him to hell with his red, white and blue.
Devil's dead, some say he's hardly. Some say the devil's dead and buried in Killarney. More say he rose again, more say he rose again, more say he rose again and joined the British Army. Are you ready for a war? For we are the English. Are you ready for a war? For we are the English soldiers. Yes, we're ready for a war. For we are the Irish. Yes, we're ready for a war. For we are the Irish soldiers. Now we only have one eye. For we are the English. Now we only have one eye, for we are the English soldiers. Now we have no eyes at all, for we are the Irish. Now we have no eyes at all, for we are the Irish soldiers. Now we only have one arm, for we are the English. Now we only have one arm, for we are the English soldiers. Now we have no arms at all, for we are the Irish. Now we have no arms at all, for we are the Irish soldiers. Now we only have one leg, for we are the English. Now we only have one leg, for we are the English soldiers. Now we have no legs at all, for we are the Irish. Now we have no legs at all, for we are the Irish soldiers. Now we are all dead and gone, for we are the English. Now we are all dead and gone, for we are the English soldiers. And now we're all alive again, for we are the Irish. Now we're all alive again, for we are the Irish soldiers. Off the long ladder and down the short rope, the hell of King Billy and God bless the Pope. If that doesn't do, we'll tear him in two, we'll send him to hell with his red, white and blue.
I spent it in good company, and all the harm that e'er I've done, alas, it was to none but me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass, good night and joy be with you. Oh, all the comrades that e'er I had are sorry for my going away, and all the sweethearts that e'er I had would wish me one more day to stay. But since it calls unto my lot that I should rise, and you should not, I'll gently rise, and I'll softly call, good night, and joy be with you all.
God bless.